following the unveiling of Eastman Kodak's Cold War satellite last month, we decided to keep looking into the company's history to find any more hidden gems. And it isn't just cameras and film. Believe it or not, it's hand grenades. Dan Gross found the interesting piece from the World War II era, and he has this report.
I loved checking out that satellite, so I wanted to do just a bit more digging. I found myself at the Military History Society of Rochester and was blown away by the displays. Rochester's military history goes even back to the War of 1812, when a group of militia dragoons drove out the British from a raid on Charlotte Beach. Now, a lot of that history is in manufacturing, too. Eastman Kodak, along with Bausch and Lomb, made optical equipment, Carlson made radios, and a postal company even made metal for new carbines. But the one that stuck out to me was a World War II Eastman Kodak grenade. The company tried to come up with a grenade that would explode on contact rather than use a time fuse, and here was the result.
The real problem with it was is that it wasn't reliable. Sometimes a hard jolt would be enough, and of course if you happen to drop it in front of you, that could be, you know, contact as well. And according to urban legend, it got the nickname Beano because during testing someone threw one up in the air, came down and hit him on the head, so he'd be no more.
Now the Beano never saw any widespread use or success. But of course, Eastman Kodak had a large number of positive contributions, including the iconic cameras, optics, and even this device. Now, it would send out a radio wave and detonate the anti-aircraft shell it was attached to when it was near an enemy plane. Dan Gross, News 8.
I'm going to remember Beano forever.